A big thank you for inviting us to speak today, and it's been a really inspiring morning. The project we're talking about feels a little bit different to some of the ones that we've heard about so far, but firstly, just a little bit about historic royal palaces. This is Hampton Court Palace, and it's a tale of two palaces, really. At the front here, you can see the large Tudor Palace, which was home to Henry VIII, and at the back, the Baroque Palace, which William and Mary had built. And they knocked down large swathes of Tudor Palace to build the Baroque Palace. Hampton Court turned 500 years old in 2015, and we were set the challenge to come up with a project of a kind of scale and impact and vision that was befitting that 500-year anniversary. So this is our cause. It's to help everyone explore the story of how monarchs and people have shaped society in some of the greatest palaces ever built. And it's really our cause that inspired our project. And it was to ask children and young people to take the driving seat for the year and to help them explore and share those stories. And really the things that defined the project were the opportunity to really think big for a change. Learning teams don't always get to do that. And to really be very ambitious and to work at scale. And by scale, we mean with lots and lots of people. And we'll come on to talk about that in a moment. We wanted to be innovative, to do something new, particularly something new for HRP, Historic Royal Palaces. And that would leave a legacy for us as a staff team to create a sense of organisational change so that we would develop new ways of working in a co-creative way with audiences. And we wanted to take a new look at history. Some of these stories, the story of Henry VIII, divorced, beheaded, died, divorced, beheaded, survived, are so familiar to people in the UK and around the world. So how do we do that in a new way? And we thought the best way of doing this, really, was by putting our audience, in this case children and young people, at the heart of it. And by combining our professional skills and the professional skills of our partners with their creativity and imagination, we were able to nurture and showcase children and young people's talents, imagination, and creativity. And this resulted in a final film which was full of humour and joy, and we have a very short clip.
Thomas Wolsey's building a palace, and it's going to be the best palace in England.
Hey, mate. Beautiful carpets.
Hello, I'm Cardinal Wolsey, and I built this palace. I'm very rich, and I wanted to live somewhere very nice.
The key things to kind of take away from that is that it really was an invite to children and young people, their parents, carers and teachers, to come and help us make a movie for the year. And we did that in partnership with Aardman, which I'll come back to. And the movie that resulted was Royal Rascals and Us, that you've just seen. And the real emphasis was on pace and humour. I mean, how do you fit 500 years of history into just 5 minutes? That's the challenge that we set the children. And the final film, the one that you've just seen, is actually a 2D version, but we made a 3D version as well. And it was shown in 360 degrees in an igloo cinema in the centre of Base Court at Hampton Court Palace. It was also screened in cinemas across the UK and at international film festivals. The key thing is that this project is very multifaceted, so it was absolutely greater than the sum of its parts. It involved a whole year of activity that was really important. So from the beginning of the year, in 2015, all the way through, there was activities on site, and Fenella will come on to talk about those. It provided the platform for a unified programme of learning and engagement activities for schools and young people and families and community groups. It provided us a whole new suite of teacher training opportunities around animation, which were linked to the literacy curriculum, to art and design and technology. It was glued together really by a website that was there for the entire year that had a whole narrative about the project that you could follow and take part in throughout the year. And again, Fenella will talk more about that. As I've said, there was major film screening, there was dissemination by third parties, including an important partnership with Bin Weevils, and that at the heart of this was all the people that took part, so the audience responding to the amazing historical content of the site. So it involved curators and conservators working alongside us as well, and also our facilitation partners. As I said at the beginning, the ambition was to work at scale. We hoped at the beginning that we'd have 5,000 children individually contribute to the film, and that we'd have contact with around 36,000 children, young people and their adults during the course of the year. As I've said, it was to provide a regular high quality programme throughout the year, and that every child would have the opportunity to contribute. And that was our sort of promise at the beginning. Importantly, it was also around accessibility. So we ensured that we worked with local community groups in to the palace to ensure that we were also accessible to special needs schools and of children and young people of all ages. We wanted it to be fun but authentic, and we wanted it to leave a legacy for us and for the young participants. So one of the things that we really recognised was that we didn't have all the skills to do this. So we invited Aardman, who are Oscar-winning filmmakers. Some of you might be familiar with Wallace and Gromit, to come and work with us. And arts media people who were specialists in running the animation workshops, to work alongside us to shape that programme of activity. But the most important partner was the children and young people. And I just wanted to pick up on Juice's comment at the beginning that it was really about our collective imagination that drove this project.
Thank you. So let's just explore a bit more about what the participants actually experienced during the project. So every element of what you saw in that film was created by them. Children in a primary school that partnered with us did the storyboarding for the film, so they actually decided what we were going to be talking about. Those same children voiced all of the characters in the film. Families and school children drew all of the images that Aardman then cut up and animated and put into the film. Young people worked with a composer to sing all the songs and record all the orchestral music that you hear on the film. And they also created all of the sound effects using Foley workshops. So it genuinely almost had absolutely nothing to do with us. So what was the school experience like? So there on your left-hand side, you can see one of the school children drawing from source materials. So what was really important for us, for all participants in the project, was that we gave them access to historical information so that they could that could fire their imaginations to create these drawings and to create these sound effects. So everyone had some storytelling from our historical interpreters, past pleasures. They saw that sort of source material, they handled original objects so that they really got that inspiration. And then we allied that with modern technology and digital animation, we held workshops on site for those schools to play with really accessible, free to use animation technology like Puppet Pals, so that they could use their own creativity to interpret that historical information that they were being exposed to. So it was really about letting them have an authentic voice in the creation of this film. And then families, every half term, every school holiday, there was similar workshops available for families who came to visit the palace. They they also had the opportunity to share their films. We shared their films on YouTube afterwards, so they could take their memory of the day away from them and share that with their friends and family away from the site. And Alison mentioned earlier that online presence. That was also really important for giving access to the project to those people that weren't able to get to our site. So those timelines, tips on how to do your own animation, there were lots of materials there to enable you to get involved in the project, and also to submit drawings that might be included in the film by sending those through to us by email or by post. So that online element really extended the experience beyond the palace walls. And then the young people, I've mentioned that they were very involved in creating the sound effects and the music. And I think for those young people, specifically, it gave them exposure to professionals and to industries that they might be interested in working in the future. So the young people work with professional composers. Those same young people work with Foley artists. So they were really engaging with professional practice as part of this project. And then finally, this is the igloo. This is a 360-degree cinema that we put in base court for a week, and the film was shown all around you. So it was a really immersive experience, and for audiences, it was such a fun and rewarding culmination to their work. And this was the moment where people found out whether or not their image actually made it into the final film. So there was lots of moments of, oh, that's mine, yeah, that's my drawing, which was really exciting. And it was celebrating everyone's contribution and telling the story of Hampton Court. Just to touch briefly on what the impact of the project was and some of the notable outcomes, we exceeded our target of 5,000 young people, children involved in the project. As I said, we created nearly 3,000 drawings as part of the project. I think it's important to note a little bit about that audience that we did engage with. A number of them, over a third, were new to the palace, which is great. We're always looking to cultivate new audiences. But equally, a quarter of them, 25%, returned during the course of the year. So this wasn't a standalone experience for a quarter of people. It was a year-long experience for them in the same way as it was for us. They came back to see their outputs and to see the results of what they'd produced. And it's also important to just draw attention to what the learning impact of this project was. People were proud of their contributions, and we have lots of comments to that effect. And hopefully some of you will have seen the handout that we've given out, which sort of summarizes some of the impact of this project. They were proud of what they were produced. They were pleased to learn new technical skills as part of this project, but they were also surprised that HRP, the Historic Royal Palaces, did this. It changed their perceptions of our organization, which is a really significant thing for us. And they found it fun, and they found it engaging. And finally, what lessons have we learned? I won't read out all of these because you can do that for yourself. I will just highlight, though, that a project of this size comes with challenges, and how you organise your resources and find enough resources to deliver it for a whole year on an ongoing basis. And the other significant challenge, I think, was marketing for us. In spite of having a very high-profile partner like Aardman Animations, it doesn't remove the necessity of having a very comprehensive press and marketing campaign. And we started off the project with fewer visitors, fewer people engaging than we had hoped, and we really had to pay attention to that as the project ran through the year to really drive those numbers. And I think one thing I didn't put on this slide was the probably the most significant impact of all is the change it's brought about in our organisation. It really was, in spite of it being led by learning and engagement, a whole organisation project that really galvanised the audience behind galvanise the organisation behind children and young people as a critical audience for our organisation. And I think it set a benchmark for our organisation in the future that we should seek to be more and more ambitious for those people. And I should just say, you might want to just take note of the YouTube channel there where you can see the rest of the film and also the making of film at your leisure. Thank you.
Thank you very much.